And so the story basically is this, it happens all the time, but the story is a big guy called James Beach. He basically gets on a crowded flight, it's the middle seat, and he puts in this little clamp that locks the seat in front of him in place. The woman in front tries to recline, she can't. She jams the seat back, he jams the seat back up, she takes her drink and throws it in his face, and then the pilot does an emergency landing. Right? Welcome to the battle of seat reclining. And do you have a right to recline or a right to defend your knees? Actually, before I go on, Matt, let me ask you, which are you? Are you a right to recline or a right to defend your knees?
Both.
That's a new position. I like that.
Well, I don't want somebody reclining. I don't want somebody reclining on me, but I want to be reclining on the guy behind me. I almost always either have the very first seat in first class, which
Okay.
it's not a problem for people coming back to me, or I'll have the, if I'm flying business class, I'm always the guy against the back wall. So I've never had both at the same time, but I've had both. When you're against the wall and somebody comes back against you, it's the worst thing in the world because they're here now and you have nowhere to go. You're
You're
helpless.
stuck. You know,
You can't.
Matt, we're in the Jim and I are in the wrong careers. We're law professors and we always fly economy. I don't know, like you're doing something right if you're flying first in business. Let me tell you a story about like what happens. Like you like have this little curtain comes down and they bring you little hot towels. We're in the back there and people are leaning into us. It is a mess. And here's the thing, like what we're fighting over is that little wedge of space attached to the back of the seat. Is it like attached to the seat? The
Right.
button, and actually half the people we poll say, yeah, that wedge is attached to my seat. The button controls it. And what they're using when they're saying that is they're using one of just six simple stories that everyone uses to claim everything in the world. They're saying it's attached to something mine, so it's mine. And the guy in behind is saying, no, hold on a second. That's I possess that space. You know, possession is nine tenths of the law. We already covered that.
Right.
So what he's saying is, man, you're trespassing into my space. That space is mine. So that very simple recline story, that's attachment versus possession. It's two of our six stories. And that simple story is also the same issue for like how you solve climate change, how you deal with data online. Like really big issues are those exact same stories in conflict. Turns out that we go through these ownership battles all day long. And what's so important, what's so cool about the airline one is while we're like, again, you don't know about this stuff because you're like up in front, but us in back, what we realized like on this plane, like studying this wedge is like, what's going on here? What's going on is that the airlines are using a strategy that we call deliberate ambiguity. It's different from tolerated theft that we saw with HBO. Deliberate ambiguity is they know that you and I, or not you, Jim and I, are going to be back there trying to fight over this space. And they know that we're going to be polite most of the time, and we're going to use good manners. That's the point. The reason that they keep the rule ambiguous, they don't tell you what the rule is. They never tell you. They almost never enforce it. The reason they do that is it lets them sell that wedge of space twice on every seat, on every flight. They sell it to, you know, for me to recline and for Jim for his knees, or vice versa.
Right.
And they count on us working it out. It's actually a really smart strategy, and it's not just airlines. You see that throughout the economy, really smart businesses. You know, you think about rocket engineering, putting people on the moon, but the way really smart businesses make money nowadays is not the rocket engineering piece, the dials and the knobs. It's the ownership engineering piece. And the way they do it on the airlines is they keep it ambiguous so they can sell that every inch of space two times.
I love mind dog. I love you. I love having the dog be the best friend of my mind.